My name is Apoorva Halikere. We're here at the Pang Laboratory at the Child Health Institute of New Jersey at Rutgers University. And I'm actually working on the neural mechanisms of reward and how they relate to alcohol addiction. My mother and father are really hardworking because growing up I saw them always working really hard and in things that they really enjoyed doing. I think that's what really motivated me because I realized I had to do something that I'm really passionate about. So my father was always interested in science. He's actually a computer architect. He has an engineering background. So he was always interested in learning how things work. And as a child, he would always talk to me about how just everyday things in our household work, like how television works and how a car operates. So I guess that kind of drove me into always thinking about how do things work. But my specific interest was science. So I kind of applied what he taught me to the laboratory and to science. I work with stem cells in the lab that came from subjects who have alcoholism and subjects who don't have alcoholism. So we can actually use these stem cells, convert them into neurons, which are brain cells, and we can study how these brain cells communicate with each other and how they ultimately control reward behavior and how this malfunctions in the situation where someone may have alcohol addiction. Once I have mature neurons that I've created, I do a lot of electrophysiology. So this is actually a technique we use to measure and record electrical signals from these neurons, which helps us understand how they're functioning. Recently, I have evidence from my data that shows that the neurons carrying the gene variant in the mu opioid receptor actually behave differently when compared to the ones that don't have this gene variant. They actually respond differently to alcohol, which may help us understand why people with this gene variant may be more prone to developing alcoholism and other forms of drug abuse. It's extremely rewarding being able to kind of be the first one to know a new fact. You discovered something new that no one else in the world knows. This kind of a really fascinating idea. It could lead to different sorts of drug developments that can specifically target the population of people having this particular gene variant. Regardless of what the outcome of my research is, we'll learn something new about how reward behavior is mediated in the brain and how this affects human behavior. So it's like making a small discovery and putting it into a big picture of what we already know and kind of contributing to the larger picture. Although scientific research is really tedious and strenuous and many experiments don't always work, the lab atmosphere, at least here at the Pang Laboratory, is really wonderful.
So what are you going to ask?
No. Wait, let me just bring my lab.
We all work together. We collaborate with a lot of other labs. In fact, just this past summer, I had the great opportunity to go to China to learn a specific technique that we had trouble working out here in the lab. Growing up, my younger brother, as he was growing up, I guess doctors had told us that he had some developmental difficulties. For example, he had trouble learning to speak and learning different motor skills. I think this kind of was really the driving force that helped me, that helped motivate me to go into research. And this was around the same time I was working at the Douglas Developmental Disability Center with the autistic students. I got to learn, I guess, how neurological disorders manifest themselves in human beings, and it kind of made me realize how little we know about the human brain. So I guess all of this kind of at the same time put together made me realize that I could probably make a big impact by doing research. And I think it's really fascinating how our body is programmed and how it works and how it adapts to different stimuli in the environment. The ability to actually study this at a cellular level, at the level of the synapse, is what really kind of motivates me to do scientific research. It's a different way of helping people with this type of problem. Not directly by working with them one-on-one, but kind of working behind the scenes and kind of understanding how their brain is functioning. The desire to learn more is just something inherent. Like, I always just want to understand why something's happening or how it's happening, and it kind of bothers me until I don't know. So I think the combination of wanting to know and being really motivated and being really interested in whatever topic I'm working on really makes me excited about what I do.